In this video, I'm going to be doing the author ask tag, which was originally written by a Tumblr blogger known as Right on the Edge. There are a bunch of authors, and for each of those authors, there's a question that we have to answer. The first one is J.K. Rowling. What is your Hogwarts house? I strongly exhibit the traits of two Hogwarts houses. Now, try as I might, I don't think I belong to just one Hogwarts house. So I am a Slytherpuff that is partly Slytherin, partly Hufflepuff. Yes, I don't think such a combination I've ever heard of before. So yeah, that's my Hogwarts houses. Stephen King, do you believe in ghosts? I don't think anything is impossible. As in, I'm pretty open-minded about these kind of things. So yeah, I guess I would say that I do believe in ghosts. And yeah, never say never, right? The third one is John Green. If you could visit any one place, fictional or real, where would you go? Now, this is a tough one, okay? Wait, questions are asking me to pick just one thing. Those are really tough. So, I'm going to go with one fictional place and one real place. Fictional place, without a doubt, is Hogwarts. I have been dreaming about getting my Hogwarts letter since I first read the books. But, of course, that hasn't happened yet. I'm here, aren't I? A real place would be either Spain or New York. Suzanne Collins, which is one person you couldn't live without? My family. I know that is not just one person, but I couldn't live without my mom, dad, and brother. Victor Hugo, do you believe in love at first sight? No, I don't. I think that it's not love at first sight, more like attraction. It's just my opinion that you can't possibly fall in love with somebody unless you know them inside out and you accept them for who they are, all the goods and all the bads. Attraction at first sight, yes, sure, but love at first sight, no. Stephanie Meyer, if you could be a supernatural being, what would you be? Vampires for sure, not only because of the speed and the strength, but I am not a warm-blooded person. I love everything that's cold, cold climates, cold food. I can't stand sunny weather. And also, I am more of a night owl. I'm a lot more productive during the night. I can stay up all night, pull all-nighters, get all the work done. But I need to be sleeping during the day. Seventh one is F. Scott Fitzgerald. If you had unlimited funds for a day, what would you do? The natural answer is to buy a lot of books, obviously. But I already do that. So if I had unlimited funds for a day, I would book flights for me and my family to different places. I would pre-book them in advance so every month we could travel to places. Eighth one, William Shakespeare. Do you prefer tragedies or comedies? So I like comedies a lot more, but if they're anything like his works, if they are tragic comedies, then I like those too. Ninth one, Veronica Roth. What faction are you in? I am Divergent, very much like Triss, the protagonist. 10th one, David Lovato. If you could be someone else for a day, who would you be? Nobody. I'm pretty comfortable in my skin, so I'd just rather be me. The last one, H.G. Wells. You can travel to any point in time, where and when do you go? Without a doubt, I would like to travel back to England during the Victorian era. I love the classic novels that are based in the Victorian era, and I feel like even though a lot of the social norms were a little not appealing then, but I would just like to experience life as somebody living in the Victorian era is wearing gowns and corsets and going to balls and meeting friends all the time. Also writing letters to one another. So it's pretty old school and I'd like to see what that's like. So that's it for the author ask tag. If you're interested in doing this video, then I tag you. Go ahead and do it and let me know that you've done that. If you like this video and if you enjoy watching my videos in general, then please like, share and subscribe. I'll see you again later. Bye.